everybody, it's Julie. Thanks for joining me today for another Advent Journaling Process video. Today I am in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, where it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." I'm going to be using some of the Illustrated Faith Advent Kit from the Bible Journaling Kit and the Devotional Kit. And I'm also going to be using this Illustrated Faith stamp set, and I will have this linked. It has a lot of the names of God in it, and I just thought it was perfect to be able to journal these names: Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. So I'm getting these stamps, and I'm putting them around this tree. The tree already has printed on it, Prince of Peace. And then I'm putting the stamps, Wonderful, Counselor, Father, and Mighty God. Now the stamp actually says God Almighty. You can see that over to the left. But I've done some stamp surgery because I wanted it to read the way I'm used to and the way this particular Bible verse reads, which is Mighty God. I'm used to singing it in Handel's Messiah and hearing it where it says Wonderful. You know, I'm not going to sing it. But it goes on and it says, Mighty God. And so I wanted it to be more familiar to me the way I'm used to. So I did the stamp surgery. You could do that with these photopolymer stamps, as long as you're careful when you're trimming them. So I'm stamping these along the edge of the tree in a similar color. And this is from a color box set. And I will link the kit. It had a bunch of different stamps in it. They're pigment inks, and it just really goes nicely with this tree. Now the eternal stamp, which again in this version it says Everlasting Father, and this particular stamp set says Eternal Father, and they're two separate stamps. And I could put the eternal there, but it's not going to look really good. You see me doing right here, the stamp image Father didn't come out perfectly clear, so I just affixed it a little bit with my aqua brush marker. I just kind of went in there and fixed it with the ink and the aqua brush marker. So I think I'm actually just going to write in Everlasting. Now I don't have a pen that same color, so I'm going to do it in black, which means I'm going to have to balance it out with some black somewhere. So I'm stamping this in black, Mighty God, and that will balance it some. So I'll have the black in the middle. I'll write Almighty on the, no, not Almighty, Everlasting up there on the top right. And so now I'm going to stamp the date on the bottom left to balance this all out. But I'm having a hard time getting this stamp to work right now because of the branch of the tree. And I was not at a good angle. I came in at it at a side angle. So I just did it a few times, but as long as it looks like I'm intending to do it that way, then it's all good, right? Okay, so now I'm going to write in Everlasting, and I'm masking off, well, actually, I'm just taking a sticky note and putting it over where I stamped because I don't want to smear it and smudge it with my hand, with my palm. So I just put that sticky note over it, and I'm writing in Everlasting just kind of in a script to give it some visual interest. Going over it a little bit darker, and that way it writes in Everlasting Father. This particular day, I'm focusing on peace, and I'm going to use, right now, I'm going to make a little shaker card. I chose to use this piece down here that says Prince of Peace because it's a pine tree, it's a tree, and to me, trees are just peaceful images, especially if you think of a forest of trees. So I'm making a little shaker out of this glitter that I found. It's a bunch of Christmas trees. And now I'm just making a few confetti pieces to go in it. I just wanted to get some of this same cardstock confetti to go in there. I think I might be overdoing it in the shaker bag, but I'm okay with that. I'm adding in some of these pieces just to get some of that color. And I'm going to look through now some of my die cuts from the Advent line. And I found a couple of hearts that I stick in the shaker bag. I also found a pink star to put up at the top. I think, yeah, there we go. I put a star to go up at the top to just bring in that pink a little bit. And I found a couple of hearts to go in the shaker bag. And I think I'm going to take a couple of pieces out. Now I just fold this little acrylic bag, and I just got a set of them from, you know, Michael's or something. I'll provide a link. So I am just going to, after I've folded it down and stapled it closed, I'm going to put that in my Bible up at the top. I'm going to put a little bit of washi tape up at the top, but I'm going to adhere it down first, and I'm going to cover that up, especially those staples, with some washi tape. Now, I'm getting this devotional card. This was from the devotional kit, and this is what took us to Isaiah chapter 9. These devotional cards are really sweet. They're just, they're real good. They have some Bible study to it. Some of them take you into a particular passage, and some of them just lead you to some thoughts and prayers. So that's a really good Advent kit and an Advent source. This is the Illustrated Faith devotional kit. I cut out, using that devotional card, a tag with my memory, We Are Memory Keepers tab punch, and I wrote peace on it, and then I used a number label, just a little alpha number, and a sticker, and used the number 5 because this was my 5th entry. Used some washi tape and anchored the top and the bottom. Now this little ornament is from the devotional kit, and it says Promise of Peace, Isaiah 9 verse 6. And this is kind of my, well, I can't say it's my focal point. That and the tree are both my focal points. They are both. And then the little shaker bag. So between those. Now I use these trees because for me, trees are just peaceful, especially these forest pines. I grew up on a pine tree farm, and nothing is more peaceful than just a quiet forest, a quiet pine forest especially. They're just so tall, they reach up to the heavens. But even more peaceful than that is God's peace that He gives to us through Jesus. So my journaling here says, thank you for not only bringing peace, but for being peace. And then at the bottom I write, a son is given to me, because that's what this passage is. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. So I'm finishing off by just getting a little bit of splatter paint on here. You saw me put my little stars, my black stars. I'm doing this for all of my Advent entries this month as I'm journaling for Christmas and just focusing on the gift of Jesus. I'm adding a little heart because that's what it's all about, just the love of God. And I'm just doing a real whimsical outline there, make it look kind of messy. I do come in and add a little bit of this. I found a gold foil star in the devotional kit, or it might have been, actually this one was in the Bible journaling kit, and I'm going to add that. It's one of the die cuts. I add that, so I still see the pink peeking through, but that gold foiling just makes it nice and pretty. And I come in, there, that's the page, you can see the shaker. You'll see on these close-ups, these little evergreen washi tapes. I found that at Target. Thanks for joining me. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Until next time, I'll see you later. God bless. Bye-bye.